My life as a house is standing on you as a pillar. You are the one who holds my life together. I want to acknowledge that this morning, that without you, my life would not be standing. You are. So join me just for a minute. Just tell Jesus, my life, Master Jesus.
You are the pillar that holds my love. You are the pillar that holds my love. Master Jesus, you are the pillar that holds my love. Master Jesus, you are the pillar that holds my love.
instruments. The gold, my love, just the instruments. Today, but I want to talk to the women, the mothers. Mothers, everyone will benefit from this. Give me Nehemiah chapter 4, from verse 1.
Let your living waters flow over my soul. Let your Holy Spirit come and take control.
Nehemiah 4 verse 1.
Every situation that has troubled my mind, all my cares and deaths unto you I run. Let your living waters flow over my soul. Let your Holy Spirit come and take control. Every situation that has troubled my mind, all my cares and burdens unto you I run.
Hallelujah. The toilets look nice, by the way. Amen. Thank you. Thank you, Bongan. You brought all those toilet paper canisters, ne? and the soap dispensers.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, they look smart. Amen.
Amen.
But it so happened when Sanballat heard that we were rebuilding the wall, that he was furious. He was very indignant and he mocked the Jews. So it happened that when Sanballat heard that we were rebuilding the wall, that he was furious, very indignant, and he mocked. He mocked the Jews. Next verse. And he spoke before his brethren, the army of Samaria, and said, "What are these feeble Jews doing? Will they fortify themselves? Will they offer sacrifices? Will they complete it in the day? Will they revive the stones from the heaps of rubbish and stones that bend?" I've titled the sermon for today, Building in Spite of Opposition.
Amen.
Amen. Building in spite of opposition. We read here in verse 1. The Bible says Nehemiah was in a foreign land when he heard about how things were going bad where he was from. He says the walls were bent down, the gates were destroyed. It was a mess, and they brought him a message. And the Bible says he asked for permission. I'll summarize it because it starts from chapter 1. He asked for permission from a king he was serving at that time. Said, "Can you please give me a permission to go back to where I come from to go and rebuild? All the things that the enemy has done, can you allow me to just stop doing what I'm doing and go there and rebuild?" And the Bible says he went back. And truly, when he arrived, things were bad. You know, it was the temple of the Lord that was just destroyed. Things were no longer what they used to be. And the Bible says he took some of his brethren and he went around and he went and showed them. You know, sometimes things can go so wrong and be so bad and be so destroyed and find that there are people who just don't see. It had to take Nehemiah to come all the way from where he was to come back home to see that things are bad. He takes his brethren, that's in chapter 1 and chapter 2. He takes them to look around. He says, "This is the case. We have to do something about it." Amen.
Amen.
So now they've started building. They're starting to build in chapter 3. They're collecting the things and they started building. And chapter 4, we begin to realize what was happening as they were building. The people who bent down, the people who did not want things to be rebuilt. You know, there are people like that in life. The people who just never want you to rebuild your life, to rebuild anything in life. They want you to stay as you are. Every time you try, when things have gone bad, and things have been messed up, whether you messed yourself up or messed up by other people or friends or family or whatever, when things are in a bad state, there are people who are just good to help you sit the way you are and be the way you are. And they are okay with you. They are your friends as long as things are the same. Siafana song. Or you are worse than me. They are happy. But once you start and say, I am deciding, because it takes a decision.
Yeah.
Amen. I am deciding, I'm going to rebuild. I'm going to rebuild all the things that have gone bad in my life. You'll always find these people. In this case, they were called Sanballat, and the other one was Tobiah. They were just raised to make sure that this rebuilding that Nehemiah is doing, it does not go anywhere. I want you to know, people of God and the women of God and whoever you are here, that in life there's always a Sanballat and a Tobiah. Everywhere, it doesn't matter who you are. There'll always be those that as you
he was furious. There are people who get furious when you pick up the pieces.
Yeah.
When you begin to see life and in a different light, and there are people who get angry. He says they were furious and they were indignant and they begin to mock. There are people who are just raised to mock you every time you take a right step. They are there in life. They will mock you. And this is what they were saying. Next verse. And he spoke to the brethren of army of Samaria. He says, what are these feeble Jews doing? He says, what are these weak people doing? That means they are, whatever you do, they look at it as is a weak thing. You are weak, even if you are not. He says, will they fortify themselves? Will they offer sacrifice? Will they complete this in a day? Will they revive stones from the heaps of rubbish? There are people who are like this in life. And it's important that as a child of God, whatever you want to rebuild, whatever you want to do, always watch for Tobiah and Sanballat. They are there in everyone's life. Hallelujah. They are there. They could be your friends. They could be your colleagues. They could be your neighbors. They could be your family members. But they are there.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So today I want to talk about building in spite of opposition. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's go to 1 Corinthians chapter 16, verse 9. 1 Corinthians chapter 16, verse 9. I won't be long, it's Mother's Day. Yes. For a great and effective door has opened to me, and there are many adversaries. Give it to me in Message. A huge door of opportunity. A huge door of opportunity for good work has opened up here. There is also mushrooming opposition. I want you to know, people of God, that every time God opens a door for you, every time God opens an opportunity, whether it is in business, whether it's your personal life, whether it's in the workplace, every time uNkulunkulu avula umnyango, you'll always find opposition.
Yeah.
Every time God tries to lift you up, you'll always find opposition. A huge door of opportunity for good work has opened up, but there is also mushrooming opposition. Other verses it says, but there are adversaries.
Mm-hmm.
You are surrounded by adversaries. That's how life is. And you always have to have your eyes open and know that these things are there in life. And uNkulunkulu does allow opposition. God does allow adversaries.
Amen.
And we'll talk about that. God does allow. Every time something good is about to happen in your life, there will be an opposition. That you need to know. But you need to know that God does allow opposition. Why does God allow opposition? Why does God allow opposition? I'll give you the you can write down. Number one. Opposition or adversaries can reveal your inner strength to you. You know, when you've been opposed by people left, right, and center on something that is before you, and then you conquer it, you begin to understand who you are.
Amen.
You begin to understand the strength that is inside. You begin to realize what is it that you are capable of and what you can handle, because many people do not know themselves. Many people do not know how strong they are. That's why every time you ask them to do something, I can't. Because most people, they look down on themselves. Most people, they undermine the inner strength.
Amen.
That God has given. You know, inside, you can be everything outside, but there is a strength that cannot be seen by a natural eye.
Amen.
That is the inner strength. And that's the strength that many people do not know, are not aware of. And that's why they shoot themselves in the foot, they undermine themselves, they undermine their abilities. So when God allows adversary to come your way and you fight it and you win, you realize that, go girl, go man, you can do it.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So it has got a way of showing you your inner strength. Amen. Number two, adversity or opposition has a way of revealing your character and the material you're made of. It is in through opposition that you are able to understand who you are. Your character, ivela ngesikhathi se opposition.
Amen.
Amen. People whom you thought they are cowards, give them opposition. People whom you thought they could not do certain things, just release opposition in their life and you see how they just rise. You begin to see the character of a person. Why does God allow opposition? Why does God? Number three, opposition teaches you life and it teaches you humility.
Amen.
It is in opposition that you begin to be humble because you realize that you depend on someone far stronger and above you. It is in opposition that you realize what other people have gone through. And therefore, it humbles you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You begin to understand what people have gone through, and especially those who have conquered things that you are going through. It humbles you before them. Amen. Opposition, it brings this humility because you realize after you have done it that, you know what, yes, I have done it, I've conquered it, but I must have had a help supernaturally. Someone did come through because it could not be me.
Amen.
Amen. So God allows opposition because it teaches you life. It teaches you humility. You understand what it takes. Some people just don't understand. That's why they're full of nonsense. They think everything is easy. When you have made it in life, they think you got everything on a silver platter. Are you sure? And therefore they undermine everything. They look down on everything. Until they go through opposition and they go through this pain, then they realize, Oguti, it takes far more than that.
Amen.
So it teaches you life. It teaches you respect. It teaches you to acknowledge, Oguti, people go through things and people do make it. Hallelujah. So God allows this opposition. Amen.
Amen.
There are things that I'm going to skip here. Because of time, I won't go through everything that I would love to go through. This is a message on its own. Amen. Yeah. So ngizothatha nje amaqaphuqaphula. So that singathathi isikhathi eside. Amen. What do you need to do to make it through when there's opposition? What do you need to make it through? Whenever you're facing an opposition, udingani ukukhona ukuwina. Amen.
Amen.
What do you need? Number one. Let's go to Nehemiah again. Go to Nehemiah chapter 4. Give me verse 6. So we built the entire wall, was joined together up to half its height. Remember, we were reading earlier that they were experiencing what? Opposition. And this was Tobiah, who was now mocking them, mocking the steps they've taken, mocking the rising of this world, mocking the work of God. And the people who like to mock whatever work, even the work of God. You know that people are okay with you when you're drinking. When you're drinking, you're going to nightclubs and you mess up your life. But as soon as you say, I'm going back to church, hell break loose. They're okay with you. It's they're okay with you like that. But as soon as you say, no more, I'm going to God. I'm going to be born again. I'm going to give my life. Hell break loose. It's like you have made the worst sin on earth. And there are parents like that. I've had many young people complaining. My mother does not want me to come to church. My mother does not want me to come to the youth. But when I was clapping, she was okay. Amen. So the Bible says here, Nehemiah experienced this. But he did not stop. Why? They built the entire wall in spite of the opposition. The entire wall was joined together up to its height. For what? People had a mind to work. Amen. They had purpose in their heart and in their mind. People, the mind, your mind is a very powerful element of life that God has given you.
Amen.
Your mind is not just a part of the body that is sitting there decorating the head. It is given by God, and it is God who uses the mind if you allow him for good things. The devil also uses the mind.
Yeah.
You've got a powerful thing. There are two powerful, maybe three. Three. Is your tongue, is your mind, is your heart.
Amen.
Those three things, they can make and build you.
Yeah.
They can make and build you, and they can destroy you.
Yeah.
Once the thinking is not right, you can destroy yourself. You can destroy people around you. You can destroy the things you love. Once your mind is not right. Hallelujah. Once your tongue is not right, you can destroy. The same way with the very same things. Once your tongue is right, you can build lives. You can build people. You can build things with just the tongue. So he says people had a mind to work. The purpose, you must put it in your mind. Your mind, you must never allow your mind to be defeated. When I was growing, they used to tell us in sports that there is it's mind over matter. You know what it means. That means when you are in sports and you are now so tired and you feel like the muscles, they just cannot allow you. They'll tell you that use your mind.
Yeah.
Use your mind. Your mind will be able to transcend the pain you're feeling in the muscle.
Amen.
And you'll be able to win in spite of the pain that you feel. Why? Because you have purposed in your mind that I am going to do it.
Yeah.
So your mind, it's one of the biggest gifts that God has given you. People had the mind to work. They build, they finish everything. And because we are not reading, if you read in chapter 5, they tell you that because they realize that these people are so determined, they're building the wall, they mobilized even more.
Amen.
To such an extent that as they were building, the Bible says one hand was building and other hand had a spear. Their purpose that, you know what, I am not going to stop.
Amen.
It doesn't matter what you say.
Amen.
It does not matter who says what.
Amen.
I am not going to stop.
Amen.
This is a good way. I am just going to do it.
Amen.
If it means I must build with one hand and another hand has got a spear, I will do it.
Amen.
But what, it doesn't matter what it takes.
Amen.
But one thing, I am determined, I have purpose in my heart and my mind is made up.
Amen.
I got my mind made up and I won't turn back. Cause I want to see my Jesus someday.
In order to take the mind first, my mind is made up. Going to change. I'm not going to stop. People had a mind to work. Once you have a mind to work, there is no devil in hell that can stop you. Once you have a mind to do things, the devil can pull all the tricks and bring all the demons, every type of opposition you can think of. Once you have purposed in your mind, or get no pass, I get no pass. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So people had a what? Had a mind to work. You must have a mind to work. What is in the mind? In their mind is your will.
Yes.
Now that's the will. It done to your mind. Unkulunkulu makadala umuntu akamenzanga wafana nesilwane. When God created you, he did not make you like trees. He did not make you like animals and trees.
Amen.
Animals and trees, they listen to God no matter what.
Amen.
They have no ability to say no. When it's winter time, those leaves must fall.
Amen.
When it's springtime, I would not start to say, hey, Mina, I'm full of letter brown leaves in December. Never.
Yes.
Amen. God designed them that way. They have no will. Whatever the Lord says, they just do. They yield. That's why Unkulunkulu, when he speaks about you not worrying in the book of Matthew, chapter 6, he says, I look after the birds of the sky. I look after the lilies of the field. I dress them up. When I care for the birds of the sky and the lilies that are today here and tomorrow they are gone. When I look after the grass, do you think I'm not going to look after you?
Amen.
You who is made in my image.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So when we talk about the mind, we are talking about your will. Say will.
Will.
Say will.
The
kuluma ngentando yomuntu. Le uNkulunkulu ayifake emthwini. When God created you, he gave you a will. That's why God can't force you to do things.
Yes.
Amen. God presents things before you and you say, yeah or nay.
Yeah.
You want Jesus? You must be born again. No.
Yeah.
Says, yes, Jesus, my son, I gave you my son to die for you. He loved you. If you take him, this is what's going to happen to you. And then you say, yes, I want this Jesus.
Yes. Amen.
So when we talk about the mind, we talk about that part, the will.
Yes.
A human being has got a will.
Amen.
And your will is that part of you that not normal, but you would take to a ganjani. You are able to still say
yes.
No.
Yes.
You can say yes. And you can say no.
Amen.
Every human being has got that.
Amen.
That's why you can never say Satan unshoots. No, Satan how shoots? You just yielded your will.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The devil didn't.
Oh yes. Amen.
You just said yes.
Amen.
You yielded your will. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When your will is strong, I'm telling you, you watch people when they're doing boxing. That's where you see a strong will. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Even in this heavy sports like wrestling.
Yes.
You see, when in wrestling, I'm not sure if it's true or not. But boxing, because it's a true sport. Ne? It's a true sport. People wrestling, I'm not sure what they do these things. Or they're just acting. You know. Hi, Acton. Yeah, well, maybe. I'm not sure. But boxing. When they punch you, they're punching you.
Yeah.
They're not acting about speaking. You say, don't use an in. They punch you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So when you're bleeding and you are on the floor, you're truly bleeding.
Yes.
Amen. And you see the will. When they say mind over matter,
yes.
Someone who is, whom you think in this one is a KO, he can never stand again.
Amen.
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 is happening there is the mind. The pain is severe. The pain says, stay there. It's okay down there. But the mind says, you can do it again. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It says you can do it again. The pain makes you want to stay down there. But when the mind is made up, you're able to say, no, I don't belong there.
Amen.
I'll rise again and try again. Amen. I'll rise again and try again. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. So you must, it's your ability to say no. When the enemy says, stop.
Amen.
That's your will. That's your mind. When the enemy says, stop this thing, you're able to say, no.
Amen.
That ability, animals don't have it. That ability, plants don't have it. Creation do not have it. It's only the human creation that God has given that ability. That's why he says, I have made you one in my image. You are made in the likeness and the image of God. You've got godly abilities in you.
Amen.
That's why you can create things.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The problem with us is that instead of acknowledging that this ability comes from above, we want to give credit to wrong things.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's move. I've got a few minutes to go. So it's the mind to work. I'm explaining what it is a mind to work. It's your willpower. It's your ability to say no. It's your ability to resist. It's your ability to resist temptation and give up before time.
Amen.
That's a mind to work. People had a mind to work. It's your courage to pass through pain and continue. People had a mind to work. What is a mind to work? What is a mind to work? Is the ability to say no when the enemy say stop. Is your ability to resist temptation to give up before time. It's your courage to pass through pain and continue. Is your ability to ignore the circumstances and focus on the goal.
Amen.
People had a mind to work. Mind to work. When you say you ignore circumstances, you don't listen to the naysayers and the mockers. And the people who always want to see the wrong, you don't listen. You develop an ability of not listening to such.
Amen.
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 People had a mind to work. So for you to be able to make it, you need what? A mind to work.
Amen.
Amen.
And you'll find these everywhere. Amen. What is a mind to work? It's a strong determination to do something. I was listening to 702, a man who was talking about who has got a PhD. He's old, I think he's in his 60s. He says, as a young man, I graduated, I wanted to be a doctor. And I was told that my maths, you know the APS score, Hiroshima Varsity, you need a certain score to get to a certain degree. And our final score, it's lower for BA, higher for BSc, higher for engineering, higher for medicine, higher for, So it says he did not have a sufficient APS score for medicine. Therefore, he studied something else. But in his heart, because he has always wanted to be a doctor, in his heart, he went back after many years and he says, I still want to register as a doctor.
Amen.
And I think at some point they gave him a conditional exemption. And you probably have worked in the field, in the medical field, not as a doctor, you know. And then they gave him that conditional exemption of accepting him. He started studying medicine again at the age of 60. He said, I was determined because I told myself, even in my young age, that I must be a doctor. At the age of 67, he finished his PhD. They were interviewing him on 702. He says, you know, my professor, when I went back at the age of 60, one of the professors says, but you can never make it. You can never finish this. He says, but I was determined. I was determined. Say, I'm determined. Say, I'm determined. He says, I was determined. You know when you are determined? When the mind is made up. I was determined that I am going to do my 7 years. Because it takes, 5 years in medicine, and 2 years of community service in the hospitals doing, being the student doctor for 2 years in one of the government hospitals here in South Africa, I think everywhere else it applies. He says, I've got my qualification at the age of 67. I might not go and practice as a medical doctor, but I've got what I wanted to do. Amen. Hallelujah. So that's what we called what? Determination. You must be, that's what a mind to work. So we build. You will build. Amen. And it says the entire wall was joined together. Amen. That you have purpose to do. He says, for I had a what? A mind to work. When you have a mind to work, you will finish that degree. Yes. When you have a mind to work, you will get that promotion. Uzayithola leyo moto, uzayithola leyo ndlu, uzayithola leyo ngane, uzayirana leyo business. Because you have got what? A mind to work. And you'll make that business what? Successful. Amen. It won't be a one of those businesses as in Vela, Zihambe. But if you've got what? A mind to work. This will work. It doesn't matter what people say. It does not matter who does not want it, but this will work.
Shall work
at this point in time.
I take the mind of Christ
I take the mind to work.
In the name of Jesus.
And I declare upon my life
and my family
that it shall work.
Things shall work.
In Jesus' name.
I thank you for Jesus.
My Lord
and my Savior.
Even this afternoon.
I open my hands.
I open my heart.
For Jesus.
Jesus.
You are the pillar
of my life.
You are the pillar
that holds
my life together.
I receive you
as my Lord
and my Savior.
I surrender
to you.
Take over
from this point
henceforth
in Jesus' name.
I love you, Lord.
Let's give Jesus a hand.